You're welcome once again to my channel. This is a channel that is set up to help you with email marketing strategies. We've been talking about email marketing and how to use email marketing for whatever you are up to or whatever you're doing. And today we're going to be talking about a very fundamental topic that everyone that is starting out with something or reaching out to an audience, whether offline or online, needs to go through, which is how to pick a niche and provide value for your niche. You know, how to pick a niche and provide value for your niche. Because it is in the value that you provide and you communicate to your niche that, you know, drives their engagement and drives your whatever benefits or the exchange of values that happens. So the exchange of benefits that goes on from the client or from your audience to you and you to your audience, depending on the value you provide for them. So today we are basically driving in on how to pick a niche. We're going to be talking about what a niche is and you know, and how you provide value and different types of value you can provide for your niche. So basically, when you talk about niche or when you are communicating to a niche, what you are saying is that you're communicating what are you communicating, who are you communicating, and how are you going to communicate with them. That's basically what we are going to answer in today's video. So first thing I want you to understand is that there's a difference between the a niche, your ID client, and your target audience. The niche is different from your ID client and your target audience. You know, the target audience is very broad. It encompasses your ID client. There are so many clients within your target audience, and there are so many niches within that your ID clients can be catered for, or there are so many niches which your ID clients might have. So basically, what we're going to be doing now, I'll briefly explain what the niche is, ID client, and target audience before going on. So the first thing I'm talking about first is the target audience. You know, and your target audience is a group of people sharing similar demographics and psychographics. You know, when we talk about they have similar age range, maybe similar environment, background, they have similar interests, you know. It is a very broad, for instance, like the example I have here, working moms, you know, is a very big audience. You know, your audience could be working moms. They could be, it means they are moms, they have children, you know, they are working. So it's a very wide audience, you know, and people belonging to the same moms, we can categorize them based on ages, you know. This is a very wide audience, that, you know, this is a target audience, and it's quite wide. There are a lot of ID clients within your target audience. So the next thing, the difference between the target audience and the ID client, your ID client is a great fit for the problem you solve. You know, this is a picture of who your client is, or who your audience is, or the person you want to talk to. That's a picture of the person you want to be addressing, you want to be talked to. For instance, a working post-pregnancy mom, you know, working post-pregnancy mom. What I mean basically is like moms who just gave birth, you know, just coming out of childbirth, and they are working. So this is a category, this is a client. You know, you can describe this client, you can give them an image, someone that is working and someone that just gave birth. It's still a subsection of target audience. And then if you want to drive down, you want to talk about the niche, means what is the specific solution you are giving for your ideal clients. That is what you do, who you help, and the problem solved. In this case, we are applying to our category or our audience that we're talking about. Your niche will be helping post-pregnancy moms lose weight while working. This is a very highly targeted, you know, concentrated client. You are solving a specific problem, which is weight loss, for an ID client, which is moms, you know, just coming out of pregnancy. So this is like a niche market because your solution here is very specific. You're not just talking about to moms. I'm not just talking about moms that just came out of pregnancy, but moms who just came out of pregnancy who want to lose weight. So you're not just talking about pregnant moms. You're not just talking about moms. You're talking about moms just came out of pregnancy and you want to lose weight and who are working. You know, there are different solutions for moms who are not working or moms who are into some other things. So this is a very specific solution for an ideal client, and that is your niche. So remember, we have a target audience, a group of people which has a, you know, belong to similar demographics and psychographics, you know, wide range, and then we have a ID client, is a fit for the problem you want to solve. And then your niche is a specific solution for ID clients. So before you start out on your email campaigns, before you start out sending messages to your audience or start catching audience, you need to sit down and plan, okay, what message am I communicating and who am I communicating to? And then how? Because the way you speak to a mom who just is coming out of pregnancy and who is working will be different from how you speak to a mom who came out of pregnancy who is at home, or one that is doing something else. You know, this has specific, it helps you to craft your language, helps you to prepare how to communicate, you know, not just the language, how to communicate and exactly what to tell them. Because the solution for a mom who wants to lose weight that is working is different from a solution for that mom that is not working. So all these things come into play when you are preparing your messages, when you're preparing to communicate via email. This comes to your mind. Then I want to touch about how to, part of your research, you know, when you're trying to pick a niche to talk about, or when you're trying to find a niche and pick a niche, one of the key tools you can make use of is using Google. I will still come back to this video or to this topic later in some later videos to in the following videos to explain better. But quickly, let me go through it. And when you are researching your niche or you're trying to pick a niche, one of the very fantastic tools you can use is Google. So basically, you can go to Google and decide when you have a particular topic in mind. Yeah. So, for instance, if you are talking about moms and losing weight, you can go to Google and first thing you do is you need to open a new Gmail, because what we are going to be basically doing is to subscribe to email list and newsletters. So the email list and newsletters will help you to will be giving you different ideas of how people are sending emails and topics that people are talking about and things that people are sharing. Basically, this is to give you a kind of inspiration on what to write or what to share with your list or with your audience or with your niche. So after creating an email and you sign up with a fresh email, because why you need a fresh email or a new email is because you're going to be signing for a lot of newsletters or sign up on different email lists, and this your email was going to be inundated with several emails, so you can get your emails to be, you know, be filled up with different subscriptions or email newsletters and subscriptions easily. So that's why I advise that you create a new Gmail for this purpose. So after creating your Gmail, your email, you can come to Google here and search for keywords that are related to your niche. For instance, maybe you can search for you can go to Google and search for overweight moms. You can search. So what we are looking for in this search is we are looking for newsletters. So you check out opt-in pages where you can sign up for newsletters. So let's check. Let's see. Let's open the pages. Let's see if it gives us a newsletter, a place where we can sign up for a newsletter. Okay, this is actually a blog. Okay, so we have, you can subscribe here. If you look towards the right here, we have a place where you can subscribe to the blog. So you can get a news. Let's look for someone, one that has a pop-up. Let's go back. Let me see. Okay. Let's see if there's any newsletter to sign up. Okay, so we have here, stay updated. You can sign up for your email, enter your email address here and sign up. Okay, this is good. So you can join the fight for the health of all moms and babies. So you can just sign up for the site, put in your name, your email address, and sign up for the newsletter. So you can go to just look through helping your child overweight. So basically, what you are doing here, you are searching for sign up email list that you can sign up with your new email and be receiving updates, announcement, and those kind of values that you want to be sharing also to your audience. You can sign up, use your keywords, search for different keywords, and sign up for different emails on the that are related to your niche market, so that from time to time, maybe every day or every 2 days, you can check for fresh information, for inspiration. This will help you to narrow down on a niche and help you decide on which niche to, or how to better pass across the message you need. Like I said, we're going to be talking about different, in our subsequent videos, we're going to be talking about different ways in which we can research a niche. We're going to be talking about how to use YouTube, how to use Udemy, how to use Amazon to search, you know, for a niche. So basically, this is what we're going to be looking at in the video. In the next section, I'm going to be talking about how to provide value for your niche market. So let's jump in straight to that. Now to move into, you know, providing value. So now we're talking about how do you provide value for this niche that you have created. So basically, there are four or five major categories of or types of value that you can offer through your emails. And these are, you can offer, there can be announcements, you can offer values in form of announcements, you can be value in form of support or services, it can be in form of entertainment, it can be in form of latest news updates, you know, and it can be in form of news digest or email digest. So these are broad value, these are broad categories or broad types of major types of values that you can provide via your emails, you know, via your email campaign. You can send announcements, you can send, provide support services, you can do entertainment, you can do latest news, and then you can do email digest. So I'll be talking about each and every one of them. For announcements, we're talking about latest or greatest information. You know, these are information that's telling people what to do right now. You know, they are very actionable. They could be contents, like new contents, new releases, new offers, special discounts. You know, these are announcements, these are information that is telling you what to do now or how to take advantage of something at the moment. The next thing is supports, or the next type of value you can provide via email is supports and services. This is talking about customer service. Maybe you have you're a coach, or maybe you're a technical person, and then you work for a technical company, you provide technical services, and people have questions, people need to know how to tackle certain things. You can be addressing topics or issues coming up, and you can provide answers to support questions via email. You know, this is quite engaging because sometimes it requires you asking and getting feedbacks, you know, from your audience. So you can create maybe surveys and polls during this, to help you understand your audience better, to help you to provide a better support for whatever challenges they're having. And you can also provide services through this, maybe consulting services or coaching services can be done via email. You know? So you answer questions, you attend to topics, you attend to issues via this. I mean, this is particularly a very big type of value you can offer via email. Another value you can offer via email is entertainment. You can actually entertain to distract people. Maybe people are working, you know, a lot of people want to feel relieved, maybe after working for several hours, you know, after being busy with business and doing so many things, they want to relax, they want to be distracted from the bustling of the day. So you can provide jokes, puzzles, trivias, quizzes through email. You can communicate this to your list or to your audience via email. You know, this will help. This is an entertainment breaker. This is the kind of value that a lot of people actually desire, especially in the society, you know, in times when people get choked up with work a lot. So this can be a form of value that can be provided. Then another type of value, very common, is latest news. That is passing latest news, letting people know breaking news, you know, something happening, updating people on news within your niche and trending topics. You know, and news around this should be focused on targeted under the niche that you have picked, you know, or topic that has to do with the niche you're talking about. For instance, if your niche is solving weight problems, then you can be updating them with news on maybe exercises or routines that fit for working people. When there's a news, or maybe there's a new device or a new gadget that just came up, you can send news updates, you know, updating people. Maybe if, for instance, if you're into electronics, You can be sending news updates, you know, about latest electronic or news or conferences or meetings that are happening. Just updating people on what is happening around their niche and trending topics. Then the last type of value that you can offer here that I'm going to mention here is like email digest. This is kind of summation of information. Something that, this is an example, this is common with Quora. You know, Quora sometimes send you information on how to, you know, on the topics and questions or discussions that people are going on, and it's curated into topics. You know, sometimes it's not curated, they just dump the information. So it's like a summation of information for people to take a look at and to digest, to work on, to read and consume. So these are four types of values you can offer. Announcements, you can offer supports and services, you can offer entertainment, you can offer latest news, and you can offer digest. Remember, replacing a PC or phone screen doesn't change the need for a clear, precise communication. We're saying your information needs to be precise and needs to be clear, needs to be straight to the point, because this information, and this is why you need to speak to a specific niche. Without addressing a specific niche, your information will not or probably may not be as clear as you hope it will be. Click to watch this next video on 7 steps on how to grow your business using email marketing strategy. Then you can join the links to our Facebook group where you can have conversation. It's in the video. And also click subscribe and click like and subscribe to this channel. Thank you. See you.